You are welcome. So in this video we are going to learn how we can create a website using the SimDiff app. So with this app you can create up to 7 pages website. The good thing about this app is that you don't pay for hosting. They will host it for you for free. And because of that too, they have a pro plan. You have to be on that pro plan so that you can enjoy all the benefits. But you can still decide not to have that one and still enjoy it. So like you go to any app or any website, when you open it, you are supposed to register. So you enter your mail, password, you click on register. But I have done that, so I will click on cancel. Now when you register, what they will do is that they will send you a mail, then you have to go and confirm it. And that is that. So I will click on login, and then we will start from there. Good, so that small arrow there, I'll click on create a new website because I've already created another one. Now it is saying that we should choose a name. The name that they are talking about is the name people will search for. That is what they are asking here, the name. So it's lowercase, so make sure it is something short that people can easily search. Okay, now you've realized that you are not supposed to leave a space. So let me close that gap and click on it. Now it is saying the name is available. So now if you've observed, you will see that we have dots. The simdiff.com. It means that they are hosting the thing for us. That is why that their name is there. So if we had paid, they would take their name out. So they are also advertising. And it's because you have not paid. So if they are advertising, it's not a big deal. So your site will still be running. That's the most important thing. So we have our name selected. So below there, you will see a language there. We've realized that the apply is inactive. So let's go down. Then let's select English. So once the language is selected, the apply will be active. So the name is now active. So you can see that we have team down there. This is how you want the site to be, how you want the things to be seen. That is the appearance. So you select the ones that is nice. Once you select the one that is nice, you click on apply. So once you get the theme, you hit apply. So that is our theme. So here, the page that you are seeing is the home page, the first page that people will see when they search for Ransom Fire. So when you click on the menu, we have the home page and other pages. So that is the menu. We will add up to 7. So let's click 7 and go back. So that gear icon there is the settings. So we have site visitors. So anybody who will visit your site, you can see the records here. Let's go back. Now we have the next one. We have the name already. So this menu, I don't want the menu to be seen, so just click the next one. You will see that the menu icon is gone. So that is that. Now they are saying author of the site. It simply means that who created the site. So I'll put the name, my name there. Now if you want the thing to be seen, then you click and then you enable that one. So when you go to the site, you will see that it will be there as created by. Let's go back again. Now we have the ownership verification. That one, the, you follow the procedure and then you go through. So we are not going to do that. Let's go back. Good. So we are now on the social media. So this social media, you can enable it, but it will not take you to your personal social media handle. It will rather help the visitors to share your information on the various platforms. So take notes. It will not take you to the business's personal page. That is what that one is. Now you can see here, these are the pro features. So the site is unpublished. When you click on the delete icon, it means everything is gone. Now we are going to look at how we will change the color of our site. Now you can see that we have the default one. So if you don't like it, how you will change it. Now that is the header. It's where we have the title of this website. So we will do all those things. Now the small, this is the setting. The small icon, it gives you the number of sites you have created. And then it also gives you option to learn more about the pro. And then this same also gives you a approach to create a new website. So the next tool is the brush. Now with the brush, we have header. The header was what I showed you. So let's click on the header. Good. So the header here, the album, that is pre-installed images that you can use for your header. Now they are saying that when you use that one, the name of the person will be appear on your page. The unsplash tool, the same thing happens. So recognize those who put the picture there. So you have to recognize the owners. That is all. So now they have given a size. The size, if you don't use this one, you will not get a good header. That is the 1,120x373. So let's choose the image. Good. So you can see that the image has fixed in the size perfectly because I did it. That is why it has fixed perfectly. So you can see the options here. We have blurred over there. So if the one that has that yellow thing, so when you click on it, that is how the header will be. So let's apply. Now that will be our header. So the next option is the footer. Footer simply means on your website, the bottom. What do you want to be the image you want to use? Select image quickly. So the portion selected, that is what will be available or that will be seen in the footer. Now let's assume that the header, you did not design the thing. When you import any image, what the size, the preferred size will be selected. So let's see where the footer is. Yeah, there it is. Very, very small. The footer, now you've inserted a header. Then you see we have some information over there. Let's click on it. This is the message you want to be on your footer. So I will say that 2021 Ransar Fire and Safety Solutions. All right, reserved. Now what we put there is there. So let's go back to the same option there. Let's select the color. So the first one with the yellow thing, and that is what has been selected. If you don't want it, let's scroll through and pick the one you want. Now you can see that this one is nice. So let's move on to the next icon. We are still on the brush. Now you have the logo. You've seen that it's 400 by 400. You can use the JPG or the PNG. PNG simply means the image has no background. And with the logo, if you use the PNG, it's better. So this logo is a PNG file. You've seen that it has no background. Now I will not crop because it has fit in perfectly. So let me click on apply. Now they are saying I should describe the image. Let me put in logo there. If you don't describe it, that is it. There it is, very, very nice. So if the logo was having a background, then the background will cover the image of the person holding the extinguisher. That is why I say you should use the PNG. So let's move on and see the next option. So we are on the font. So this one, the one that you want, you select. The one highlighted is the one selected. Let's move on to the next one, shape. So the one selected is the first one. If you want to change it, you can change it. Now let's move to the next item. So with the favicon, when you are using a PC, when you are using phone, you don't see it. You realize that in the browser, you see a logo of that company. That is the favicon, but you can't use it because it's not a free feature, it's a premium package. So the favicon, if you browse any website, you see it there. So the texture, let's see what is there. Now these are the designs that the texture comes with it. So let's select one and we will look at how it is. Apply. So look carefully where we have the header image. You can see that there are some designs over there. When you scroll down to, so look carefully, it is there. When you come down to where we have the footer, that one too, you can see it there. That is the texture. It adds beauty to your stuff. Now let's finish with the settings at the brush under the dark column. We have the strip, so we have the dark and light, but it's inactive, so let's enable it. So when you click on it, now you've seen that where we have the title of this website, is there's a rectangular shape there, and then the place is a little bit darker. So the strip that we type or we selected, that is what it does. So going forward, let's select a title for our website. So click on it. Now the title should be the business name. If you are doing it for yourself or if it's for someone, then you type the name for that business. So I'll type in the name, Ransom, Fire and Safety. Now you can see that this color, our background is already red. So click on it and change it to white. Now you can see that when you come down, you have colors used in this set. We have background, page and footer, selected tab and all those things. The frame tabs, you can change any color on the page. Once you are done, you click on apply. So you change any color. Now let's apply again for the name to appear on our home page. So you see it has come. Now our home page is now taking shape. So this is the first page people will visit. When you send the link to people, when this is where the link will take them. So make sure your home page is very nice and attractive. So in the, let me change the layout. So let me click on that triangular sign there. So they are saying the title of this blog, let's change it. Now let's click on the standard. So I want something that the image will be small. Now it is saying that, what is this site about? So you tell the people the piece of information you want them to read. So you can say about us, then you hit apply. Now it is saying a title for this blog. What you are doing is that the thing that you are putting in this particular blog, you just put something like introduction, the title for the blog. So let me say Ransom Fire. Then it is saying, tell your visitors what this blog is about. Now let's click on that. So let's tell them, we said about us. So now when you read down, it says Ransom Fire and Safety Solution is a. So let's change the image. So choose good image. Don't forget that we are working on our homepage. So pick a very good and quality image. Very, very nice. So the moment someone visits your page, the person knows, okay, they are into safety. So let's move. So if you click on the menu icon, you click on the page you want to change the name, you type in the name. If you click on the menu item, if you want to add another page to, you see add a new page. Like I said in the beginning, you can create up to 7 pages. So that is how you do it. Now don't forget that they will ask you, what is this page about? You type it there, then you select image, you put in your text. So that is how you add pages. These are the steps you follow to add any page. You edit, you put in your images. You want to add bulletin to make it nice, you can do that. Select all, and then you can see that you have bold, italic, then you select the bulletin, or if you want to use 1, 2, 3, any of them. So all the pages that you'll be creating, you'll see aside the main title, you see this subtitle there. The main one, then the subtitle. So the services here, put images of about the things you do. Don't forget to add the image description. So our services page is ready. So now with the about us, that is, you are telling all the people who visit your website what your business is about. So your mission, your vision, your operations and everything, you copy and you paste to the next page, which will be the contact us page. So with this one, the template is contact by email, but we are going to add our contacts to this, our number, so that people can call us. Now don't forget that this layout, you can change it. When you click on the triangular sign over there, you can change the, now the selected only text, that is title block. So you can change it. Just go through and select the ones that you think you want to use. So now let's put in something, because you are saying contact us, so give some information that people should follow, some guidelines. Let's assume that you will not put in anything, then when you publish your site, it will not appear to the viewers that a title for this, no, they will not see. So you can see that we have enabled the chat form. Unless you are online, other than that, the message the people will send you, if you are not online, you only see the message, you can never reply. So that is how the thing is. So let's click on add block, a new block, so that we can insert our phone number and stuff. So we will choose the title block because we want to insert our phone number. We don't actually need the picture. So let's select the first one. So let's add this one. The email is a form they will fill. Then you will get the notification. So let's give a title for this block. We can say that give us a call. So here, let's add our email. Now the one that are the forms over there, they will fill it and then you will get a notification. But here, once you put your email and then they click on it, they can send you a message directly. So let's put the email here. You select and you bold it. If you want to underline too, you can do it. Okay, so you can see that the things that we inserted are there. Now let's do arrangement of the block on this page. Let's click on that hand icon. So you've seen that we have arrow pointing up and arrow pointing down. So let's bring the email down and then we will send the contact one up so that that one will come first. Good. So after that, you click on the pencil icon there so that it will be saved. Yes. So now they can either call you or you can fill this form. So the email address you use to create the account when you were registering on the app, that is, the app will send a notification on the app will send a notification that someone has filled a form, then you have to respond. So let's assume that you are creating the thing for someone, then it is either you create a new email for them or they will give you an email. We are done with this contact us. So now we have four pages. Let's add another page. So we have empty page, a home, we have a home page.